despite assurances from Russian President Vladimir Putin yesterday that Russia would stop at Crimea, many are concerned about the fate of eastern Ukraine. Our chief foreign affairs correspondent Margaret Warner arrived in the city of Donetsk this morning. It has been the scene of fierce, sometimes deadly street battles in the last week between pro-Russian and pro-Ukrainian demonstrators. I spoke to Margaret a short time ago. Margaret, hello. First of all, this news that Ukraine is announcing plans to pull all of its troops out of Crimea. What are you hearing?
Well, Judy, this news just broke in the last hour, so we called the aide-de-camp of the colonel commanding the Balbek military base, which is right near the capital, whom we interviewed in our piece on Friday. And this aide-de-camp said, as far as they know, they have received no orders yet. They're still just hunkered down. However, those orders are not surprising from Kiev in that the acting president said something like a week or 10 days ago, they do not have the forces to send down to Crimea to rescue Crimea or fight back for Crimea because they will not be able to defend this region where I am now, which is southeastern Ukraine, right along the Russian border.
And indeed, you've now moved into a different part of Ukraine. How different does it feel, Margaret, from Crimea?
You know, really different, Judy, and I'm kind of surprised because I've read so much about the pro-Russia demonstrations. They've actually had more violence here than they ever had in Crimea, with a demonstrator, pro-Ukrainian demonstrator, killed just last Thursday in a sort of face-off between the two camps in Lenin Square, three blocks from here. But the difference is that in Crimea, which is 75% to 80% ethnic Russian, the pro-Russian fervor was really palpable. People walked around the streets with Russian flags in their lapels or wearing this sort of orange and black symbol of Russian strength and symbolism. And there was an election going on. Here, it is much more subtle. There is pro-Russian sentiment here. It clearly has been aroused. And in fact, I met with the governor today at some length, this billionaire businessman who's agreed to be the governor here, who says off camera that really it's generated by these 100 or 200 Russian specialists, he called them, who come in here. They've got the whole playbook. They know what to do. But they also can get 4,000 or 5,000 people out in a square to demonstrate in favor of closer ties or even union with Russia. So there is something going on here, but you do not have, for instance, Russian or Russian-linked military forces on every corner the way you did in Crimea. So as I said, it's a more subtle story, but it's one that Kiev is very worried about.
So are you picking up reaction, though, Margaret, to Putin's, the Russians taking Crimea?
Well, yes, Judy, at a shopping center tonight, I would say the number one reaction was one of grief. You know, Crimea is a place that Ukrainians love to go to vacation. They have fabulous hiking, great beaches. And people told us they were actually very sad about this. One man said, I'm feeling more Ukrainian now and that part of my country has been taken away. There was a gentleman who said he'd lived in Belarus and he thought it was marvelous that some Ukrainians, that is, those in Crimea, could go back to the mother country. So there's a split. The thing that, again, Kiev has to be worried about is a couple of people we talked to said, you know, I don't want to be part of Russia. I have relatives there. I don't really want to live in Russia. But I'm not going to go out and fight for this Ukrainian government either. Every single leader since we got independence has been a crook. Let them go out and fight. And this is really the problem that the Kiev government faces, which is to make people feel they have a stake in Ukraine as an independent country.
So given that, what do you think the chances are that eastern Ukraine could be the next flashpoint?
There is no doubt that the sort of Putin playbook is being followed here. For instance, Saturday, they had demonstrations in 11 different cities almost at the same time. Now, that is not an accident. And so there is some kind of operation going on here. We haven't seen it ourselves because we've only been here less than 24 hours. We haven't seen a demonstration yet. But what the Kiev government is worried about is that, as I said, they do tap into some pro-Russian sentiment here, again, as in Crimea, people who say, well, we watch Russian television, we hear about how much better conditions are there, people get higher pensions and higher benefits and better wages. Whether that's true or not remains to be seen. But I think that the central government in Kiev does have a legitimacy problem. They have not won all the hearts and minds of people here in this part of Ukraine. And so they have appointed, for instance, these very wealthy oligarchs, billionaire businessmen, one of whom, Sergei Taruta, we met at length with today, who really have been brought in to try to sort of rally the troops and also restore order, bringing some of the management skills they have from business to what has been a very unmanageable situation here.
Margaret Warner continuing to do great reporting from Ukraine. Thank you.
Thanks, Judy.